Hello, welcome back. And today we're going to try something different. We're going to play chess today. Nice calm game of chess. 10 minutes. My rank is in the 500s, but I'm willing to take some criticism in the comments section what you guys think I should do. I'm not going to commentate for all of this, but I'm going to leave this unedited so that you can really get a sense of how I'm playing, if that makes sense. So, what I like to do is I like to play this and then this right here at some point in the game. I know it doesn't work on higher level opponents, but on a lower level opponent, it can work sometimes. So that's what I'm gonna play right here. Yeah. So now what I'm gonna do is I can go with a bad fork. But what I'm most likely gonna get out of this is a lost bishop. Oh, by resignation. All right. So we got the win, and I think what I'll do this time is I'll play another one for this video. So, we'll see. We'll see how much we can get out. My hope is that I can get one quality game out of this. One really good game for you guys to watch. Now, like I said, I'm not the best at chess, and I'm never gonna be as good as Magnus Carlsen. I've played chess for a couple months now, if even. So, and I know how to play, but and I know basic chess theory, but that's about it. That's about it for me. So, and like I said, I'm gonna try and play my bishop right here, so that I can try and take the queen early. Hopefully, he'll take this. No, yeah. So this is typically what happens when I try to do it. But every so often, I can get the I can get the queen there. If I can do that, then it either they'll resignate or the win will come a lot easier. Now I'm behind by one, so I need to be a little more conservative because I wasn't paying attention to, I didn't pay attention as much to my pawn play in the center of the board. I need to get more pieces towards the center. So, I'll take that. I'm gonna lose this. I'm gonna play that, which is gonna force him now to take the knight out, and I'm gonna try and move my knight here. Or I can move my bishop here, depending on what his move is, and check. But I don't really see a benefit to that. Ooh, he left his bishop. That's an interesting move. I'll play knight e4. Oh, I forgot that I didn't take. Damn it. That's a poor decision by me. Oh man. So hopefully, yeah, okay. Am I willing to trade? I'm willing to trade. I'm willing to trade. And hopefully, maybe he'll come down and take this queen, and we'll trade queens. If not, that's fine. I'm not in a good spot right now. Anyway, so we're even in material. Hopefully, he'll come down and we'll trade queens. That's fine with me. That's what I like trading queens. What I want to do is I am going to play this. Now he can take the knight, I'll take, and then we can take care of the bishop here. He'll go up for a couple seconds, but I'll be able to recapture and hopefully even it out. Maybe even take the lead. material through that move. If he decides to take the knight, he doesn't want to take the knight. Interesting. So if he's not going to take the knight, then I'm going to move the knight. I'll move it there. Now, also in the comment section, I'd like for you guys to give me some more suggestions on what you guys want to see me play. I know I started up the Hearts of Iron 4 series, Part 2 recently came out. But what other games? Well, would you like to, do you, how often do you want to see a Part 3 to the Hearts of Iron 4 series? Or do you want to see me post something different? Totally up to the comments, whatever the democracy states, whatever the democracy wants, if that makes sense. So we'll put in check. I don't see what I lose out of this. Hopefully maybe we can get him to go this way and I can put him in a check that way. No. Okay. Now what I want to do is I want to try and take this bishop here. Oh, that wasn't a good move. I want to take, so I'm trading again. Unless he decides to move this. So you have to move it like right here. But that's about it for safety. If he wants to move the bishop, it only goes there. No, do I want to trade? No, I probably want to stay away from trading right now. Actually, I'll trade. I'll trade. He's gonna come take. Alright. Castle? No. I wasn't sure if I could castle or not. I'll put him in check here. Then he's gonna move that way. So we'll move the pawn up to protect the bishop. And I see his king's moving, dancing around a lot, which is very interesting. If he moves back here, then I'll. Huh, he's attacking the rook. We'll play Rook D1. So hopefully we can get the take there. I assume he'll move his rook there, though. Which if he does, I'm not going to take. Maybe what I can do is I can move this rook over to F1. Puts me in check. Okay. So where do I want to move? Let's go. I want to So there's the rook on the move. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move the king there. So that I can take if he decides to take with the rook. So that then I gain material and we'd even out in overall material. Now what I want to do is I want to put this here so now I can move my king out of the way in case I need to. I'll take that. He can take that. I'll play king there to protect the pawn. I can definitely tell I'm down material. Yeah. That's a good move. That's a really good move. So I'll do Let's see. So if I do that, if I do that, he takes, I take. So it becomes 3-3, and then I gain 5. I lose 5. So that'd be a completely even trade. Let's see if he takes it. If he comes down, then actually I gain out of this. So I'm gonna gain out of it little bit. Don't think I'm gonna get the win here. But I don't think this was a bad game either. I think I will analyze it afterwards. Maybe I'll go over, we'll see how many blunders I made. But this was not the best outing for me. I think I went down early and just caused catastrophe. He shouldn't be moving these pawns down here to pressure my rook into protecting this pawn or getting these pawns instead of don't want to move the king down here because I want to make sure he has the entire first rank available to him. He moves there. Does that put me in checkmate? No. And is he gonna promote? No. Interesting. He's gonna take that now. Or he should take that, yeah. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just move this here. I'm probably gonna lose it. I've understood the fact that I've lost, but we'll at least finish. It's not gonna be a good finish, but oh well. We'll see how bad it was in the game analysis afterwards. So I don't know, maybe he'll accept a draw. I'll resign there. Yeah. Let's see. Seven missed wins. Or not seven missed wins. I had two missed wins, dang. This was not a good game for me. And he had three brilliant moves. I only had one great move, dang. Yeah. I call. Yeah, that was a good move. Even in the moment. Yeah. Like at that point, I just didn't care. Want to know what his great moves were. So, a lot of blunders in this game, as we can see. Oh, that was a great move. This steps away, the only move that works. Huh. It's a rook by developing. Seven going good move. Ah. All right. Well, I think I got time for one more. I'll play one more. We full screener. So I'm gonna try here immediately for my H5 BC G. Oh, it's already been blocked, so we will not be doing that anymore. Knight there to protect the pawn, and I'm already put in check. Hopefully, he'll return his bishop to one of these three squares. Or he'll bring it back over here. I don't know. It's not in an unsafe location. So if he moves his bishop here, then I'm gonna move my knight. So I'm gonna move my knight now to protect it. Or should I leave it? I should probably leave it. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take there. There we go. So now that I feel a lot better about my position than I once did, than I first did. I can just move it back now. Yeah. So I'm actually ahead in material now, so I can actually make trade-offs and have it benefit me throughout the match. So he's now probably gonna take. No, he's not gonna take. All right, I'll corner him off then, and I'll force him to flee that way. And I'm actually gonna play this. Let's see what he does. So, see if he brings it. He can't bring it over here. So the only move that'll save it would be over here. And since I'm ahead, I'm gonna trade off. And it also brings out the rook. So we gotta keep in mind that the rook is now open. Let's see. Move bishop there. Bishop g7. And we'll go c5. Take. And then that also allows me to threaten the bishop. But he moves the bishop. Alright. Now we don't want to do that. I say we move the queen. Actually, let's castle. Let's castle. Give the king protection on this side. I do tend to like castling. So I'll protect this pawn here. I think I'm gonna move the queen. He's moving faster than me, which I'm not really used to. My opponent, at least. I gets bishop c4, that'd be nice. Let's try that. Oh, there's a knight there. I bet you the knight's gonna take. No, okay. Right. That's good. Good, good, good. And I'm actually even now in trading, so. I'll take the pawn there, which now leaves the entire H column open for this rook. So, I'm not worried about him coming down here, though. He can take that if he wants. Or he's not going to. So if he's not going to take, I'm going to threaten this knight now and see what happens. See how he reacts. He's going to move it away. I'm surprised he didn't do was bishop to h7. I wonder if that'll be considered a miss win or not. Feeling good because I feel like I have a good grasp over the center of the board in this game, which I believe is a key to winning. All right, so we're ahead material by one. We're gonna save the rook there. I wouldn't want to lose that now, would we? Now, what if I go? Now, my thought is to go queen. No. We have both these columns, which I like. No. How can I put the king in check? If I go here. He's only got one move available, which is to move up, if I'm correct. Unless he moves something in the way, but I don't think he can. Let me see if. I don't know if I have mate right now, though. Is this mate? No, because the knight can take. Oh, let's try it. Let's see. Knight takes. I'll just go over here and get the or I'll just move the rook over to here. And we'll see what happens there. So I think what's gonna end up happening is it's gonna be knight takes. Interesting. Very, very interesting. I'll take that way. He can take that way. I'll take that way. Which I'm now up 13 in material. And I still have my queen, which puts me in a really good spot. You didn't even take the bishop with the rook that way, which is interesting as well. I know I've probably said the word interesting a lot. Whenever I watch this back, I'm gonna be annoyed of how much I said that, but I feel like it's the best word to use. And I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try and move the queen there and then there to hopefully get a checkmate. So hopefully he doesn't have mate in one. So that I can play either. So like if I move my queen there, it's not mate because he can move here or there. Oh man. Man, am I stupid. But I can take that. I can take the knight, which is a step in the right direction. is I need to find a way to get what do you call the rook right there? The rook. I need to get the rook. I'm gonna put him in check. About halfway through our timers. I'll put him in check again. I mean, he'll have to go here or here. So, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna threaten to take the bishop here. And then I'll take it. And then I can do king h7. So I'll take and put in check. And from there, I will move up here. And then I'll go there, and or I go there. And hopefully the king's trapped at that point, and I can get checkmate. Checkmate. Boom. So I was able to get two wins, one by resignation, one by checkmate, and one loss, which I certainly did not play my best, and I certainly did not play my best in this one too. Nine blunders and two missed wins still. But I did feel a lot better about that one than I did in my first the last game that I played. So if you want to see me play more chess, I'm open for it. I like chess. If you have any suggestions, then put them in the comments. If I suck, tell me I suck. But, I mean.